वन मोमेंट। वन मोमेंट गाइस, सिस्टम वर्किंग बिट स्लो। वन मोमेंट, आई यूज द व्हाइट बोर्ड। So today we'll go with the next concept. There is a female genitalia, external genitalia, that is called vulva. So vulva means external genitalia of female. They include mons, vanvis, labia, majora, labia, majora, clitoris, vestibule, okay, and related perineum are the different parts which are present in vulva. Okay, so we'll see one by one. Before that, go with the diagram. So actually there will be a vaginous intro. Vaginal introitus. Which is also called as the opening of Bartholin's duct. Opening of Bartholin's duct. At the bottom of area, the connectivity of muscle, perineum, and followed by anal outlook. So vagina is having the mainly vaginal introitus. Vaginal introitus has covered by a thick layer like structure. Which is called as labium minus. labium minus. And above of it, external urethral pore. So for the discharge of the urine, so this external urethral pore is connected with bladder. And these are the ureters. So this outermost area between the labia minus and the external muscular structure, which is called as labium major. Labium major. On the top of it, this small muscular bubble will be there, which is called as clitoris. Clitoris. So this is the primitive part of male penis. Clitoris is the primitive part of male penis, male reproductive organ, external organ, there is a penis. But it is a primitive in structure, very small in structure. So this clitoris was covered by a skin membrane, is called as frenum. Frenum. On the top of area, the top layer of the area is called as monas pubis. It's also called as veneris. Okay, so this will be the basic structure of female reproductive system. In this case, if you see mom's veneris, or mons pubis. Is a abdominal area. It is a pad of subcutaneous connective tissue, subcutaneous connective tissue lying in front of pubis and is covered by pubic hair in adult female. Labia majora. Vulva is bounded on each side. Labia majora is bounded on the vagina on each side, this side and this side. By the elevated and foldings of skin. Elevated and foldings of skin. And having subcutaneous tissue. subcutaneous tissue. Its inner surface is hairless. Inner surface is hairless. Upper surface will come under Mons pubis, which is a haired, but inner area is a hairless. The outer surface is covered by sebaceous glands. The outer surface is covered by sebaceous glands, sweat glands, and hair follicles, but not heads, but hair follicles. It is homologous like a scrotum in male. This is homologous like scrotum in male. The bag-like structure. So in a male reproductive organ, it looks like a scrotum. It looks like a male reproductive organ. There is a penis. Clitoris looks like a penis. And it looks like a scrotum. Okay. In male, labia major equal to scrotum in male. Labia major is in female. Similarly, clitoris in female, penis in male. Similar organ, similar structures. Next, labia minor. Labia minor. Labia minora is two thin foldings of skin, two thin foldings, outer and inner, two thin foldings of a membrane, projects just within the labia majora, lower part of minora fuses across the middle and form a fold of the skin. This is called as a fourth sheet. This is called as fourth sheet. The inner folding structure of the skin is called as fourth sheet. FourChette. Chette. Double D. Coming to clitoris. Clitoris is a small cylindrical and erectile body made by two layers of labia majora fused over here. And it made it. It is also made up of two erectile bodies called corpora cavernosa. Clitoris is made up of a tissue called corpora cavernosa. The skin which covers the clitoris is called as prepuce or frenum. It is also called as a prepuce or frenum. At the terminal part of the vagina, the urethra is located, the terminal part of the clitoris. which is generally connected with the bladder, with the ureter, and which will be used for the discharge of the urine. In case of female, urinal discharge and gamete transport will be from through the two different parts. But in case of a male, it is the same part. So few positions are very important scientifically, because when you go for the competitive exam, the questions may come like this. Urethral opening. Where is the urethral opening? Lies on anterior end. Lies on anterior end. Vaginal orifice. Vaginal orifice lies on posterior end. Lies on posterior end. It is incompletely closed by the septum of mucous membrane called hymen. Vaginal orifice is incompletely covered by hymen. So actually, there is a one said that the vaginal orifice is covered by basically a thin membrane. This is a representation of virginity in from the ancient time. In fact, it's wrong, because in the daily lifestyle, this hymen layer, which will cover this vaginal orifice, will break out in the daily practices like cycling, running, jogging, for any kind of a basic parameter. With the physical activities of the body, generally this orifice will get opens up once the age come around 9 years. Next, opening of Bertholis, duct of either side. Opening of Bertholis, duct on either side. Opening of Bertholis is a duct on both sides. So opening of Bertholis ducts will be there on the both the sides, this side and this side, both the side, it will be there. Next one. What is Bertholin gland? Singular, Bertholis gland is a plural. Bertholin gland. It is homologous like a Cowper's gland. Where Cowper gland? It is similar like a Cowper gland. Where you have seen this Cowper gland?
Male genital. Yes,
in a male genital system, you have seen Cowper's gland. What is the other name of Cowper's gland?
Bulbourethral.
Bulbourethral gland. Good. Bulbourethral gland. In rabbit, one pair of gland, Bertholin glands were found on lateral side of vagina. Please make a note. In rabbit, one pair is found on lateral side of vagina. It also opens into vagina, lateral side, and opens into vagina, even in case of rabbit. In case of male, it will be around both the side, it will be located. Top to bottom in a circle way, this Bartholin gland is located. But in case of rabbit, both the sides corner is open and openings are open into the vaginal end. In human, female also, it's a one pair on each side. One pair on each side. One pair on both sides in case of rabbit. But here, one pair one side. So two pairs will be there, both the sides. So these glands are also called the greater or lesser vestibular gland. Greater or lesser vestibular gland. Greater or lesser vestibular gland. Okay, now we will see scheme of gametogenesis. Is it clear till here, guys? Dactional genitalia, did you understand? Any doubts? Any doubts? Is it clear? Not clear?
Clear, sir.
Any doubt? Shall I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next one. Scheme showing gametogenesis. Scheme showing gametogenesis. As I told you, inside the ovaries, ovarian follicles will develop. But in which stage these eggs are? In which stage these eggs are? In the meiosis? Prophase 1. Prophase 1.
Prophase 1, sir.
Yeah. These are also called as the primordial germ cells. Primordial germ cells. The parental cells are called as the primordial germ cells. The cells which are responsible to form them. These ovarian follicles are responsible primordial germ cells. Basically, it will undergo into mitosis and they will form oogonia. Oogonia. By 25th week of pregnancy in girl child. So now imagine you have primary oocytes. Guys, if I put like this, if I put like one on a top, like small single one, small one, it's called like a primary always, secondary, tertiary, like that. Okay, so primary oocyte. So by 25th week we'll get primary oocytes, which is a diploid, which is having 44 plus XX chromosomes, 44 plus XX chromosomes. Because it's a female mother cell, so XX chromosomes only will be there. But in case of male, 44 plus xy will be there, but here 44 plus xx in case of female. So here the arrested first mitotic division will take place. Arrested first meiotic division will take place in prophase stage. In prophase stage during the birth. So now primary oocytes are there at the time of birth of a girl child. And further they will complete first meiotic division and further they will develop into two cells. After first meiotic division we will get two cells which are diploid, right? So now one is secondary oocyte and one is polar body, which have 22 plus x, 22 plus x. Sorry. Forty-four plus XX. So one polar body and one oocyte we got. So polar body will not further will move. It will extinct. It will degenerate. But oocyte two, secondary oocyte, further it will go. Meiosis two, it will go under meiosis two. And arrested at metaphase. Arrested at metaphase. And it will produce again two more gametes. One is fertilized ovulation. So this is called as ovulation. This stage is called as ovulation. In a ovulation, one egg can be fertilized egg. And non-fertilized egg. Fertilized egg and non-fertilized egg. A non-fertilized egg can be degenerated. And fertilizing egg can further develop into ovum. Which is 23x, and here one polar body, second polar body. Same concept in a simple manner. Primordial germ cell, which is called as ovum stem cell, OSC, ovum stem cell. Then we have seen sperm stem cell, right? SSC. Here, ovum stem cell. Further, it will develop into oogonia. and it will develop into primary oocyte. This primary oocyte is a diploid 2NN condition which has 44 plus XX chromosomes. This primary oocyte will undergo meiosis 1. It will give you one polar body, one polar cell, and one primary oocyte, sorry, secondary oocyte. Here primary oocyte, now it will give them secondary oocyte. Further, secondary oocyte will undergo meiosis 2, where you will get one fertilized egg and other one second polar body. Okay. In an ovum, 23 plus X chromosomes will be there. 23 plus X chromosomes. So, out of 4X, actually here 2 come, here 2 should come, here 1 should come. So, 1, 2, 3, 4X should come, but out of 4, 3X will get degenerated. Only one egg will form. Understood, guys? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
When you compare with megasporogenesis, how this three, is it same or different? Megasporogenesis in a plant and ovulation in humans, more like it look, process looks like same or different? Megasporogenesis in plants, ovulation in humans, both look same or different?
Same, sir. Little similar, sir.
Similar.
Same, sir.
Yeah. 1 plus 3. How this 3 will disintegrate in case of megasporogenesis? What is the enzyme involved in disintegration of these 3 polar bodies? Enzyme involved in megasporogenesis to disintegrate these 3 polar cells.
Calase, sir.
Calase, good. Calase enzyme. Very important bit for NEET. Please remember, calase enzyme. But here, gene orientations will stop their further mitosis. Okay. Then what is the difference further? After this,
excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, actually, calase enzyme is involved in microsporogenesis only, no, sir.
No, ma'am. Microsporogenesis is a pollen grain development. It's a megasporogenesis I'm speaking about. In megasporogenesis, out of 4, 3 will disintegrate. Calase enzyme will be there for the maturation of the pollen grains inside the tapetum. That will not, that enzyme will not involve in the egg disintegration in case of microsporogenesis. But in case of macrosporogenesis, it will involve. I think you are referring to the Truman's biology, right?
No, sir.
Okay. Then why you got that doubt? You are suspecting that it's in microsporogenesis?
No, sir. That class only I had very clear clarity, sir.
Okay. Actually, it's a megasporogenesis, not micro. Microsporogenesis is in pollen grain development. Megasporogenesis means ovule development. So, Calase enzyme, I told in the megasporogenesis only, not in microsporogenesis. In fact, in microsporogenesis also, calase enzyme is there for the pollen grain nourishment, but you will get confused. At the same time, it is not required for you at 10 plus 1 level for the NEET examination. That's why that point I didn't touch. But if you refer Truman's biology book, you will see that. Clear?
Okay.
Yeah. So it's simple. Don't get confused. Microsporogenesis, megasporogenesis. When you compare pollen grain and ovary, which one is a bigger in size, which one is smaller in size? Pollen or ovary? Ovule. Is it pollen is a bigger or ovule is bigger size?
Ovules.
So megasporogenesis related to female reproductive part, that is a ovule. Okay. Pollen grain is very small related to male reproductive system. Then process further go on. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Anyone have confusion in that megasporogenesis and microsporogenesis? Okay, let me explain you side by side. That's better. I think you have confusion in megasporogenesis and microsporogenesis with male reproductive and female reproductive system. Should I explain? Can I explain or not required?
Yes, sir.
So what happened here? One moment. First, in case of plants. Megasporogenesis. First, what will be there? Parenchyma. Parenchyma to archisporial cell. Archisporial cell, periclinal division, so that it will give you two cells. One is PPC, PSC. Right? PPC will give you three layers. Epidermis, middle layer, endodermis. And PSC further will go under meiosis. When it undergo meiosis, it will give you four cells. All four cells will develop pollen grains. Right? Further, each pollen grain will undergo two mitotic division. In mitotic division, I'm taking one pollen grain example.
Excuse me, sir. This is megasporogenesis only, no, sir.
Okay, I'm sorry. First, I'm explaining microsporogenesis. Microsporogenesis. I'm sorry, don't get confused. I got confused actually. Okay. So here, pollen grain will undergo into two levels of mitosis. Mitosis one, where you will get one nuclei will become two nuclei. Okay. Please, number 24. Okay. Out of these two nuclei, one is a vegetative, one is generative. Further, generative undergoes into mitosis two. So, two generative, one vegetative will come, irregular shape. This is a microsporogenesis. Then, coming to megasporogenesis. In megasporogenesis, there is a parenchyma tissue. This parenchyma tissue develops into archegonial tissue. Further, archegonial tissue will undergoes into periclinal division, which will develop into integuments. So, which will develop into integuments? PPC. And coming to PSC, further it will undergo into meiosis. So, when it undergoes into meiosis, it will give you four gametes, which are 1N in condition, It is a PPC, is a 2N in condition. Here also 2N in condition. Okay, out of four, three will be disintegrated with chelation enzyme. Further, this single egg undergoes into mitosis one. So that what will happen? Two eggs will come. Then mitosis two. It will give you four eggs. Then mitosis three. It will give you eight nuclei.
Ma?
Please mute your mic. Mute your mic. Okay, so finally we got seven cell, eight nucleated condition. But here, one cell, three nucleated condition. One cell, three nucleus. In that, one is vegetative, two is generative. But here, eight nucleus, seven cell. One polar body, polar cell, integuments, antipodals. Excel and integuments. Understand, guys? Am I right what I mentioned here? Integuments and antipodals?
Synergids and antipodals.
Sorry?
Synergids, sir.
Yeah, synergids. I'm sorry. At the time, everything I am taking, I'm just getting confused. Synergids. Two synergids. Is it clear now? Comparison? Guys, cleared or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then coming to male reproductive system, there will be seminiferous tubule. If you take up this seminiferous tubule, outside the seminiferous tubule, there will be Leydig cells. From the anterior pituitary gland, straight away it will release this follicle stimulating hormone, which will hit Leydig cells. Further, this Leydig cells will release the hormone called testosterone. This testosterone will hit SSC, sperm stem cell, which will undergoes into meiosis so that it will develop 4 sperms. So each sperm having 22 plus X, 22 plus Y, taken twice. From one oocyte, you will get 4 spermatozoa. Each chromosome is 2 times, like, no, two male sperms, 2 female sperms will release. Understand? Guys, you understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then coming to female, oocyte. This oocyte undergoes into meiosis. Actually, four cells has to form. But here, what will happen? In a meiosis one, it will give you 2 cells. It's a primary oocyte, so you'll get secondary oocyte and polar body. And secondary oocyte for that will give you 1 ovum or egg and 1 polar body. So finally here, you will get only 1 egg, 1 ovum. After the birth here at prophase 1, it's stagnated. Further, that process will continue after the maturity during the process of menstrual cycle. Further, egg development will occur and finally, ovum will release. So, inside this development completely from prophase 1 to, from prophase 1 of meiosis 1 to, and meiosis completed and egg developed, and egg will be released into the fallopian tube. When, in the sense, on a day 14 of menstrual cycle. So day 1 to day 13, development will occur inside the ovum, and day 14 only, egg will release inside the fallopian tube. Understand, guys? So this complete process will occur inside the ovary, and process time period 1 to 13 days of menstrual cycle. And 14th to 17th day, egg is active and very comfortable time to form the zygote. From 18th to till 28th day, the egg membrane will become very thick and egg will become old and energy will be lost. So it's not a good fertilizing period for the egg. Egg become aged. And finally, after 28th day, menstrual cycle discharge will occur. Along with endometrial wall, egg, everything will get discharged. Even when you compare sperm size, ovum size, egg size, when you compare, sperm size is very small, and worm size is very big. Now understood, guys? All four process. This will be in case of a plant. This will be in case of human. Process more like looks similar. Is it clear or any doubts? Please open up mouth, guys.
Clear,
sir. See, one thing I'll tell you, don't feel hesitated to answer or to respond here. It is purely for your knowledge purpose. It is very important. This lesson is basically very important, as even when you are in class 11, I was telling you. For any organism, basic motivation of any organism in this nature is reproducing their N1. In that scenario, it is essential to have the knowledge on the reproductive system of the plants and reproductive system of the humans. Then only as the most smart and intelligent and genius animal on this planet Earth, we can able to take care of the nature. Okay, don't feel like disgusting. Just receive it as in the form of science only. It's my sincere request and effort to everyone. Please consider it as a science. This is a matter up to your mind how you are going to receive. Right? This is a purely, it is a concept or a subject which we are going to discuss. And it is up to your mind and your mindset how you are going to receive. But as your teacher, I'm just taking it as a science, a brilliant science. Still any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. So tomorrow, I will start ovulation, how egg will develop in the ovary, how it will develop day to day, and how it will release, what is the menstrual cycle, during the menstrual cycle, what are the hormonal changes, then how zygote will form, further, how that zygote will develop into a offspring. These are all the concepts we are going to discuss in next 4 days. Okay, here I'm just closing. And as usual, on Thursday, you have a physics and chemistry and computer science, right? Or English? Subjective and objective. Guys, please respond.
Yes,
what was the plan on Thursday? Exam plan on Thursday?
Physics, chemistry, objective, morning and subjective at afternoon.
Objective in the morning and computer science or English?
English, sir.
English subjective in the evening. Okay. And timings?
9 to 12 in the morning and 2 to 5 in the afternoon.
Okay, then. So this is on Thursday and coming Sunday. Coming Sunday will be biology, math, objective, biology, math, and computer science subjective. One moment, please be online, everyone. Hello, sir. Sir, good morning, sir. So here, on Sunday, biology, math, objective in the morning session, 9 to 12, and evening, 2 to 5, subjective examination will be there. Here, one most important thing regarding biology, syllabus will be sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Now itself, I'm telling you, start your preparation. For next Sunday, sexual reproduction, flowering plants, botany-related topic, flowering plants, okay? So now itself, I have announced my syllabus. So start your preparation. Any more doubts?
So that study or timetable, it's confusing, sir. Can you?
Okay, I'll tell you. Regarding study hours, we are trying to make it, we are trying to split into 8 to 9 batches. So totally, once all student loads, it will become 15 batches. In this 15 batches, daily one faculty will come. Okay, in each and every group, even teacher also will be there. We are including each and every student into the group. It is not matter of your fees or something, study hour, we are including everyone. So during that time, teachers will come. So most of the time, study hour timings will fix it, particularly between 11 to 3 between, we'll try to plan it. Okay, it is a fixed timetable, 2 hours daily, 40 plus 40 minutes. 40 minutes, 40 minutes, 2 hours will be there. So 25 students plus one faculty will load in the meeting. Regarding that all, we'll update it soon. And regarding Rajesh sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, 2 minutes time, sir, please.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Okay.
So anyone have a group B list? Group B list, anyone having? No one. Okay. Once again, in a group B, I will post that list of 25 students who belong to me. So I request all of you, please inform to them to join in the group by using the link. Okay. So,
sir, still I didn't get the group link, sir.
Sorry?
Still, I didn't get the group link, sir. Invite group in the study
hour. That's what I'm saying. Still, students were not added. We will add you. Because in the office, you submitted one number. In a WhatsApp classes, you are with one number. And in Nalanda, which number you provided us last year, that is a different number. So in which number you are, we are unable to catch you. That is a problem. And even we are adding you the numbers which you have given in the school. But immediately the people are leaving from the meeting. What should we do? Like, you know, from the WhatsApp group, they are leaving. We don't know why, what the reason. Okay. So technical reason, technical problem is there from your end. We are unable to catch you people. That is the reason why I'm telling. I have given you the link. Whoever comes in my group B list, please use that link and join as per the your interested mobile number. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, then for Krishnagiri students, what do you have?
Krishnagiri students also will make it, ma'am. Don't worry. We need little time to establish. The main problem is now, Sanjana, the problem is like we have to produce the marks for 11th and 12th now. The 12th, your senior people are leaving out now. So for them, we are in evaluation process. We are in making the statements. In that, we are a bit busy. It will take a couple of days more to stabilize the situation. So please wait for some time. We'll streamline everything.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And here I'm just closing my session and catch you tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
So today do we have study hour class?
No, ma'am. Today also we are in stabilization process. Most probably from tomorrow or day after tomorrow we'll start.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. Today we are going to contact you, everyone. Don't worry.
Good morning, ma. Good morning to Vanda. See here, in the last class we discussed regarding the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. We discussed what is the expression for the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. We know, ma, 2p divided by 4 pi s naught into 1 divided by r square minus a square into, that is r. So in case of the short dipole, r value is greater than the a. So we are getting 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 divided by r square. So we can say that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line is inversely proportional to the r cube. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line, it is inversely proportional to the dipole. And we know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line, which direction, ma? See here, electric field intensity due to the dipole. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. Electric field due to the dipole along the axial line is equal to, we know that in case of the sharp dipole, that is 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 divided by r cube. Which direction? Along the direction of the dipole moment. Along the direction of dipole moment. This is regarding to the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. This is what we discussed in the last class. These two also take ma. This is a subjective point of view and objective point of view. Very, 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 very important derivations ma. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. Inversely proportional to the R cube. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. In case of all we are discussing about the short dipole, 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 by r cube. Along which direction? Along the direction of the dipole moment. Now the next, very, 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 very important derivation for the subjective point of view. Subjective point of view, very important derivation. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Electric field intensity. Electric field intensity. Electric field intensity due to the dipole. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along equatorial line. Along equatorial line. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Take the statement ma. Very, 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 very important derivation to the subjective point of view. Either the axial line or the equatorial line, they're asking in the subjective examination. Both combinedly 5 marks question they're asking. Otherwise, any one of the question they're asking for 3 marks, along with that, one problem they will include, then totally 5 marks question. Okay, let us see now. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Now here, first of all, initially consider one of the dipole. This is the negative charge and this one is the positive charge. Negative charge and positive charge. This is the center of the dipole. Yeah. Now see here. Electric field intensity due to this dipole along the equatorial line, I am asking. Consider this is the particular point. At a particular point P, at a distance given to the R. Electric field intensity due to the dipole at a particular point P, at a distance R, I am asking. At a particular point P, at a distance R, all the distances we are measuring from the center of the dipole. Now, here the statement. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along equatorial line at a particular point P at a particular point B, at a distance r, at a particular point B, at a distance r, at a distance r. First, take this statement along with the diagram take. Electric field is due to the dipole along the equatorial line at a particular point B at a distance r. Get the diagram. Now I'm going to rub now. Okay, see here. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line at a particular point B at a particular distance r. Let a diagram. Now, electric field intensity due to this negative charge at a particular point B. So, due to the negative charge, electric field intensity is a vector quantity. Its direction is radially inward. So, this is the negatively charged particle. I am representing that one is E1. Now, again, due to this positive charge, electric field intensity is a vector quantity. Its direction is radially, due to the positive charge, direction is radially outward. So we can say that. Its direction is radially outward. That I am representing as E2. Okay, now see here. Electric field intensity due to the negative charge, that is in the E1, radially inward direction, due to the positive charge, so radially outward direction, that is the E1 and E2. Now we can say that electric field intensity due to the negative charge, Now here also I am giving these as a point. This is the point A, this is the point B. At this particular point P you are going to calculate. Okay. Now from that, due to the negative charge is E1. E1 is equal to what is the expression ma? K into Q dot by what is the R value now? So this is the totally length of the dipole. That is nothing but this is A, this one also A, then we can say that the dipole length is nothing but the 2A. So, electric field intensity due to the charge Q from that particular point to the charge, whatever the separation is there, that is the distance we are taking. This is A, this is R. Then whatever is separation now, under that is R square plus A square. Now we can say that even value is equal to simply k means 1 by 4 pi, don't represent the k mass. One subjective point of view, you should not write with the k. 1 by 4 pi f naught you have to write. So, 1 by 4 pi f naught. Now, what about the separation mark between the charge to the particular point under root r square plus a square? Then we can say that 1 by 4 pi f naught into q divided by under root r square plus a square, the whole square. Then we can say that as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q divided by that is r square plus a square bracket. This is the E1. Now similarly, electric field intensity due to the positive charge at that particular point we also calculate. Now we can say that electrical intensity, you don't write like this, EFI. You don't write like this. While writing the subjective point of view, you have to represent with electric field intensity. You should not write with EFI. You should write each and every point. So electric field intensity due to the positive charge. Due to positive charge is E2. Then we can say that E2 is equal to what we are getting, ma? Due to this charge at a particular distance. What about distance, ma? This is R, this is A. Then we can say that this one also under root R square plus A square. So we can say from that K into that is Q divided by under root. Don't write the K, ma. So 1/4 pi r. Objective point of view can represent, but to subjective point of view, how to represent it? 1/4 pi r. 1/4 pi r into Q divided by under root R square plus A square the whole square. Then again here also we are getting 1/4 pi r into the T Q divided by R square plus A square value in this in the E2. Now from this, by observing this one, even value and E2 value both are equal in magnitude. Therefore, we can say that E1 is equal to E2 is equal to E, that is equal to 1/4 pi r into Q divided by R square plus A square we are getting. This is the E1 value and E2 value both are equal. That is equal to E. That means 1/4 pi r into Q divided by R square plus A square. Till here, take my first of all. Now from this, here only represent. This is certain angle theta. This one also making an angle theta. From here onwards, continuation I will give now. E2 is equal to E only. E1 also equal to E only. E1 is equal to E. E2 is equal to E. That is equal to 1/4 pi r into Q divided by R square plus A square. Subjective point of view. Very, 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 very important derivation, ma. Now again, see here, ma. Net field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line only, na, I am asking you. So from that we can say, see here. This is making an angle theta means this one also making an angle theta. This is making an angle theta means then this one also making the same angle theta. This one also making the same angle theta. Now see here, ma, this is E2 is equal to E makes an angle theta means then we can say this component is nothing but E cos theta. Other component is nothing but E sin theta. Here I am representing E2 is equal to E making an angle theta. That's why this is the E cos theta. This is the E cos theta. And another component that is E sin theta. Now again, this one also E1 is equal to E makes an angle theta. Then we can say this component is nothing but E cos theta. And another component is nothing but E sin theta. Another component in the symbol E sin theta. Here E sin theta, here E sin theta gets cancelled. Now if you consider here, this is the E cos theta and this one also E cos theta. Both are acting along the same direction, just added. Then we can see that the net field intensity along the equatorial line is equal to E cos theta plus E cos theta, that is equal to 2E cos theta. Which direction, ma? Actually, dipole moment, this is the direction of the dipole moment from the negative charge toward the positive charge. So we can say that this is opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Then net field intensity direction opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. This is the direction of the dipole moment. In case of the axial line, along the direction of the dipole moment, we got the electric field intensity. Now, in case of the equatorial line, opposite to the direction of the dipole moment, we are going to get the electric field intensity. So, in case of the axial line means, we know that 2p divided by 4 pi s naught into R divided by R square minus A square, the whole square we got. If it is a short dipole, 2P divided by 4 pi S naught into 1 by R cube you got. Now, in case of the equatorial line, what is the expression? Let us see now. 2E cos theta. So, from that, 2E into E means what is the expression? We know, 1 by 4 pi S naught. 1 by 4 pi S naught. Sorry. That means E means what we got, 1 by 4 pi F naught into 2 divided by, that is R square plus A square. This is the electric field intensity. Into the cos theta. Cos theta means what, ma? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. A divided by, this is the hypotenuse, under root A square plus R square. R under root R square plus A square. Then we can say that. Then we can say that. That is 2 into A. So from that, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into this is 1 by 4 pi epsilon into 2 into 2A. Here the 2 is there. This is the 2 into A. You can write 2 into 2A divided by R square plus A square into R square plus A square whole power 1 by A. Then we can say R square plus A square into R square plus A square whole power 1 by 2. So from that we can say that as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 into 2A is called as the dipole moment P divided by R square plus A square whole power 3 by 2. This is the net field intensity. Along which direction, ma? Opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Here I will represent the net field intensity along the equatorial line. Net field intensity along the equatorial line of a dipole is equal to that is 1 by 4 pi S naught into P divided by R square plus A square whole power 3 by 2. This is the net field intensity, which direction means opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. So simply we can write that as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught means K. kp divided by r square plus a square whole power 3 by 2. Now again, in case of the short dipole, r value greater than the a. So r value is greater than the a means then a is negligible. Then we can say that the net field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Net field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P divided by R square whole power 3 by 2 means what you can write? R cube. This is the net field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. In case of the which dipole? My short dipole. Simply, what is the expression? 1 by 4 pi epsilon into P divided by R cube. That's all. Take ma. Now here also we can say that field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line is inversely proportional to the R cube. First, we'll take this. Subjective point of view, either along the axial line or along the equatorial line, they're asking. In case of the axial line means opposite to the direction of the dipole. Axial line means along the direction of the dipole moment, we are getting the field intensity. In case of the equatorial line means opposite to the direction of the dipole moment, we are getting the electric field intensity. In case of the axial line, what is the expression? 2p by 4 pi f naught into r divided by r square minus a square whole square we got. So that's why short dipole means 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 by r2. In case of the equatorial line, 1 by 4 pi f naught into p divided by r square plus a square whole power 3 divided by 2 we are getting. In case of the short dipole, so 1 by 4 pi f naught into p divided by r cube. That's all. Now we can say that. Next one. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line is also inversely proportional to the R cube. Then we can say that electric field intensity due to the dipole, also called the net field intensity, simply called as electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line is inversely proportional to the R cube. That's all. This is regarding the dipole mass. Now again, I am asking to give the relation between the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line as well as equatorial line. I am asking. So in case of the short dipole, see here, ma, E axial is equal to. What is the expression, ma? 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into that is 1 by r cube. Then, in case of the equatorial line, in case of the equatorial land. That means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P divided by R cube. P divided by R cube. Or otherwise, simply you can write the, this one also 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 P divided by R cube is equal to 1 by, here also equatorial line is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P divided by R cube. From this, what the relation you can give, ma? E axial is nothing but this one, 1 by 4 pi epsilon to 2 P divided by R cube. E equatorial, this one, 1 by 4 pi epsilon to P divided by R cube. So from that we can say that E axial is equal to 2 times that of the E equatorial, 2 into this one means what we are getting, 1 by 4 pi epsilon to 2 P by R cube. That only, na? So we can say that E axial is equal to the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line is equal to the 2 times that of electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Along the equatorial line. So axial field intensity is equal to 2 times that of equatorial field intensity. That's all. This is the relation between the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line as well as equatorial line. If I given to you, in case of the short dipole, electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line, some value is given to you. The what is the electric field intensity due to this, the same dipole along the axial line at the same distance, I am asking me into 2 only, na? For example, electric field intensity due to the short dipole along the axial line, some value is given in that question. What is the electric field intensity due to the same dipole along the equatorial line at the same distance, I am asking is what you can say? E equatorial is equal to 1 by 2 times the E axial. That's all. That is regarding the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line as well as along the equatorial line. Now the next one, electric field intensity due to the dipole at any point. Electric field intensity due to the dipole at any point. This is from objective point of view, not to the subjective point of view. Electric field intensity due to the dipole at any point. So at any point means I discuss till now only along the axial line, along the equatorial line. If it is a short dipole along the axial line means what is the expression we know? 2 P divided by 4 pi epsilon into 1 by R cube. If it is a equatorial line means what is the expression? So P divided by 1 by 4 pi epsilon into 1 by R cube. That is what we got in case of the axial line as well as in case of the equatorial line of the dipole. Now at any point I am asking. So for that one also, what we discussed, those two concepts are required. See here. Simply, while representing the objective point of view, 1 by 4 pi epsilon I will simply represent the k. So if it is asking in the subjective point of view, k place must ensure don't represent with the k. K place you have to represent with 1 by 4 pi epsilon. That's a mandatory thing. So if you didn't represent with the 1 by 4 pi epsilon, they will cut one mark. Now see here, let us consider the dipole. This is the one of the dipole. Let's say negative charge. This is the positive charge. And this one is the center of the dipole. From here to here, this is A. From here to here, this one also A. This is the length of the dipole. The two equal and unlike charges are separated by the small distance is called the dipole. Due to this dipole, we know that the dipole of dipole moment is nothing but the P bar. The dipole of dipole moment P bar is the direction always from the negative charge toward the positive charge. Asking to calculate the field intensity, the space is not sufficient. Once again, I will put in here. this is a negative charge. This one is the positive charge. This is the center of the dipole. This is the length A. This one also the length in the A. So we know that the dipole of dipole moment always from the negative charge toward the positive charge. This is the direction of the dipole moment, P bar. Okay, from the negative charge toward the positive charge. Now I am asking to calculate the electric field intensity due to this dipole along the axial line already discussed here. Along the equatorial line already we discussed. At any point I am asking, that point the axial line means theta value 0 ma. Equatorial line means theta value is 90 degree. At any point, if it is making an angle 30 degree given means, 45 degree given means, 60 degree given means, how to find out the electric field? They won't give directly along the axial line, along the equatorial line. While solving the problems, they will give at a particular angle 30 degree, particular angle 45 degree, at a particular angle 60 degree. From the center of the dipole, what is the electric field intensity they are asking? How to calculate now? All the distances are measured from the center of the dipole. For example, this is the particular point. This is the particular point. From the center of the dipole to that particular point, which is at a distance in the middle of the R. This is at a distance in the middle of the R. See here, ma. This is a particular point. This is the particular point P, which is at a particular distance in the R from the center of the dipole, making an angle theta. Here I am giving to you, this is making an angle theta. So that particular point P at a distance R from the center of the dipole, making an angle theta with the horizontal, find out the electric field intensity due to this dipole at that particular point I am asking. That's my question. See here, ma. Here I am following. This is the R, na? This is the P bar makes an angle theta means, what about this component? This is the P cos theta. One is the P cos theta. Other one means P sin theta, normal to that one. One is the P cos theta, other one is the P sin theta. Once again, this is the one of the dipole. Having the dipole moment in the P, always from the negative charge toward the positive charge, the P makes an angle theta. So this is the P makes an angle theta with this angle. That's why this is P cos theta. Other one is P sin theta. Now, if you consider this is the dipole of dipole moment, not the P. How much more P cos theta? To this dipole moment, this particular point, always the dipole moment from the negative toward the positive. Forget about the P. This is the one of the dipole having the dipole moment in a thing, but P cos theta. Always the dipole moment from the negative charge toward the positive charge. To this one, to this dipole, this particular point in a thing, but which point, ma? Axial point. We know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line means which direction? Along the direction of the dipole movement. So this is the direction. I am representing that one as E1. So simply we can say that E1 means electric field intensity due to the dipole of dipole moment, not the P. What is that? Dipole moment P cos theta along the axial line at a distance in the R1. So we can say that E1 is equal to, what is the expression for the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line? Short dipole only, ma. Along the axial line, what is the expression we know, ma? 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 by r cube. Simply, I am representing with 2kp. P means p naught, p cos theta now. P otherwise, without confusion, directly I will represent, ma. 2p divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into, that is 1 by r cube. This is the even value. Where p means p naught. Now p means what here? P cos theta also simply represent with P cos theta. Then we are getting 2P cos theta divided by 4 pi F naught into 1 divided by R cube, that is the even value. Now again, so this is the dipole. See here, this is the dipole of dipole moment in nothing but the P cos theta. So this dipole, that particular point in nothing but the equatorial point only na, along the equatorial point, what the direction of the electric field intensity ma? Okay. Along the axial line means along the direction of the dipole moment. Along the equatorial line means opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Dipole moment which direction? Downward. To that opposite direction means upward. This is the direction of the electric field intensity we are getting now. This is the direction of the electric field intensity we are getting. That is the E2. At a particular distance R, then we know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line in a thing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon into P divided by R2. Simply here also. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into that is P divided by R cube, where P means here P na P sin theta na, that is P sin theta. Then P sin theta divided by R cube, that is the even value and E2 value. Now I am asking to calculate the net field intensity. See here, this E1 and E2 both are perpendicular to each other, because this P cos theta, P sin theta perpendicular na, then that even value and E2 value are perpendicular to each other, then we are getting the resultant field intensity along the horizontal. Sorry. Then we are getting the resultant field intensity. This is the direction of the resultant field intensity in between these two vectors. This is the resultant field intensity, also called the net field intensity. Then we can say from that, net field intensity is equal to the resultant field intensity is equal to under root E1 square plus E2 square. Then we can say that under root E1 means this one, 2P cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by R cube the whole square, plus again 1 by 4 pi F naught into P sin theta divided by the R cube the whole square. So from that we can say that that is a P divided by 1 by 4 pi F naught is taken as common. P divided by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube the whole square is taken at the common. Then what's remaining here, that is 2 cos theta only remaining whole square. That means simply I am representing as 4 cos square theta. Plus here what's remaining ma? This is the sin theta whole square. Plus sin square theta. So from that we can say this everything is taken outside. That is nothing but P divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by that is R cube into under root. So 4 cos square theta means you can write 3 cos square theta plus cos square theta. That is 3 cos square theta plus cos square theta plus sin square theta. Now we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta value is equal to 1. First till here take ma. Okay, so from that further simplification, then what we are getting here? So from that what we are getting now, the net field intensity P divided by 4 pi F naught into that is 1 by R cube into this is under root 3 cos square theta plus 1 we are getting. That is the net field intensity due to the dipole along the at any point we can say that. Net field intensity due to the dipole at any point, this is P intensity due to the dipole at any point is equal to P divided by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube into that is under root 3 cos square theta plus 1 we are getting. For example, you can check it out this one with along the axial line as well as along the equatorial line. We know already along the axial line means 2p by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube we got. For example, along the axial line, that one first application, theta value is equal to 0 means along the axial line like this one, Lena, then with respect to that particular point, this is the theta, this is the particular point P means the dipole moment, that particular point both are acting along the same direction. Then we can say the theta value is equal to 0. Along axial line, we can say. Along axial line, theta value is equal to 0. Substitute my theta value is equal to 0, cos 0 value is equal to 1. Under root 3 plus 1 means 4, root 4 we are getting. Root 4 means 2 only. So we can say that P divided by 4 pi F naught into that is 1 by R cube into that is under root 3 plus 1. That is nothing but root 4 is nothing but the 2. Then we can say that as 2p divided by 1 by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube. That is the expression for the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. 2p by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube. That is nothing but electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line. That is. Now, similarly, along the equatorial line, I am asking theta value how much for now? Equatorial line means 90 degree. Same thing will come, a different value will come. Just check it out. B. Theta value is equal to 90 degree. That is a thing about along equatorial line. Along the equatorial line. Along the equatorial line. So what we are getting, my theta value 90 means cos 90 value 0. 0 plus 1 means 1. Under root 1 means 1. So from that we can say that P divided by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube into under root, that is 0 plus 1 we are getting. So we can say that one as P divided by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube. That is equal to root 1 means 1 only, na? Is equal to the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line. Along the equatorial line. This is already we discussed. Same thing only, na? We got it also. Now we can say that at any point electric field intensity due to the dipole I am asking means P divided by 4 pi F naught into 1 by R cube into under root 3 cos square theta plus 1. That is the electric field intensity due to the dipole at any point. That is simple. Now again I am asking, what is the angle made by the resultant P intensity with the horizontal? So with the even how much? with the horizontal, how much I am asking? Just a minute.
Excuse me, sir.
Ashmita, ask your doubt, ma'am.
Sir, can you please repeat again how you have considered E2, sir?
Simple. See here, ma'am. Once again, I will discuss both E1 and E2. This is the dipole of dipole moment in a thimble, the P bar. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This P bar makes an angle theta with this axis, means this is the P cos theta, other than the P standard. This one clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you consider this is the dipole of dipole moment, now don't consider the P. Now, because of the P, we got that if the P cos theta is the one, P sin theta is the another one. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, to this P cos theta, this one also dipole momentum only now. To this P cos theta, that particular point, this is nothing but the dipole of dipole momentum in nothing but now the P cos theta. To this P cos theta, that particular point where ma? Along the axial line. Is it clear, ma? That point is clear?
Yes, sir.
So, to the axial line, we know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line in a thimble. Along the direction of the dipole movement, this is the direction I am representing with E1. We know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line in a thimble 2p divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 by r cube. That I am representing as E1. Clear, ma?
Yes, sir.
Now again, coming to the to this dipole, this is the P cos theta, other one is the P sin theta. One is the P cos theta, other one is the P sin. Those two are perpendicular to each other only, na?
Yes, sir.
Horizontal component and vertical component. Now see here, ma. Now this is the dipole of dipole moment in a thimble, P sin theta. Dipole of dipole moment in a thimble, P sin theta. So this P sin theta, that particular point in a thimble along the equatorial line. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Perpendicular bisector of a dipole.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So this P sin theta, that particular point in a thimble, equatorial line. Now we know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line in your direction, opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Which direction of dipole moment? Downward. To that opposite direction is which direction, ma? Upward. At that particular point. Clear?
Once again, sir.
This is the dipole of dipole moment in a thimble, the P sin theta. This is the P sin theta. To this P sin theta, that particular point in a thimble, perpendicular bisector of a dipole, that is called as the equatorial point. We know that electric field intensity due to the dipole along the equatorial line in the direction opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. To this dipole moment, P sin theta, opposite direction in this one only na, at that particular point I am representing that one as E2. Now E2 means what, ma? We know that 1 by 4 pi f naught into now 3 plus P sin theta divided by R cube, we are representing that in the E1 and E2. So from that, this E1 value and E2 value both are perpendicular to each other under root E1 square plus E2 square. And finally, we got the expression electric field intensity due to the dipole at any point in a thing, but P divided by 4 pi f naught into 1 by r cubed into under root 3 cos square theta plus 1. Simply, this you can represent with K. Kp by r cubed into under root 3 cos square theta plus 1. That's all. That is in a thing, but the net field intensity due to the dipole at any point. But I am not representing with the K, because to the subjective point of view, you have to represent with 1 by 4 pi f naught. If you didn't miss that 1 by 4 pi f naught, if you represent with the K also, they will cut the 1 mark. So I am not representing. So simply I am representing with 1 by 4 pi f naught. Clear, ma, all of you?
Yes, sir.
This is regarding the net field intensity due to the dipole at any point. Again, they are asking, what is the angle made by the resultant field intensity with the E1? They will give the diagram itself. What is the angle made by the alpha with the E1? They are asking. That is the question. What is the alpha value? They are asking in the question. How to find out the alpha? Can you say now? This is the E2 means this one also E2 only. Now this is the direction of the E2 only. Now Now apply tan alpha, ma. Tan alpha means what we are getting. Tan theta means opposite by adjacent side. So we can say from that, tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent side. So without giving the problem based upon the dipole, they won't give the equations from the chapter mark, the objective point active. 99% one of the question based upon the dipole they will give. Especially this concept. Applying tan alpha. Tan alpha means what we are getting, ma? Opposite by adjacent side. Opposite means E2. Adjacent side means E1. We know that E2 means what we know, ma? Electric field intensity due to the dipole, P sin theta, along the equatorial line. That means 1 by 4 pi F naught into, that is P sin theta divided by R cube, whole divided by. Again, E1 means what, ma? Due to the dipole of dipole moment, P cos theta, along the axial line. So we can say that 2p cos theta divided by 4 pi f naught into, that is 1 by r cube. Here 1 by r cube, 1 by r cube. So 1 by 4 pi f naught, 1 by 4 pi f naught gets cancelled. P and p gets cancelled. Sin by cos means tan theta. Then we are getting tan theta divided by 2 is equal to tan alpha. Then we can say tan alpha is equal to 1 by 2 into tan theta. They're asking, what is the alpha value in terms of the theta they has given in the equation. So we can say that tan alpha is equal to 1 by 2 into tan theta. Then alpha is equal to tan inverse of 1 by 2 into tan theta. That's all. That is the alpha value. Again, one more time ask the question. What is the angle made by the resultant field intensity with the horizontal? Okay, first I take this one. Angle made with the net field intensity or simply called as the electric field intensity at a particular point with the horizontal they will give. The same concept will come in case of the magnetism also. Same thing, everything is same. What we are discussing in case of the electricity, same point, each and every point is same in case of the magnetism also. No change, but here electric field, there is a magnetic field, that is the only difference. Here the electric dipole moment, there is a magnetic dipole moment. Here also axial line, there is also axial line. Here also equatorial line, there is also equatorial line. Here also at any point, there is also at any point. Here also alpha, there is also alpha. Same thing, same concept again will come. Here you understand, there is nothing. Interlinked concepts all are. Okay, now again I am asking, angle made by the field intensity with the horizontal. Angle made by the field intensity, electric field intensity. Angle made by the electric field intensity with the horizontal. With the horizontal. See here now, with the horizontal means this one only, na? This is the horizontal. With the horizontal, I am asking. This is alpha. This is theta, and this one also theta. With the horizontal means what, ma? Alpha plus theta. So angle made with the resultant field intensity with the horizontal is alpha plus theta. So we can say that alpha means this one, that is equal to tan inverse of 1 by 2 into tan theta plus theta. That is nothing but the angle made with the electric field intensity with the horizontal. That's all. Many more times ask your questions. Again, to the next class, I will give some problems based upon this concept. objective point of view very, very important, ma. They are giving their questions based upon this relations only. Not one time, most of the times ask her questions. Again to you, tomorrow examination, these concepts are not there. JE means till this concept I didn't express to them, to you only I completed. So that's why to you examination portion from the electric charges, I mean properties of the electric charges, Coulomb's inverse square law, electric field intensity and their applications, electric field intensity and their applications, just the concept of the electric dipole moment only, not the electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line and along the equator line at any point, except the three concepts, electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line, along the equatorial line, at any point, except the three concepts, everything you are going to write the tomorrow examination. Clear all of you? Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
The tomorrow examination portion, except the three concepts. What are those three concepts? Electric field intensity due to the dipole along the axial line, along the equatorial line, at any point, except the three concepts, you are going to write the examination. Again, to the next examination, based upon the three concepts, 5 marks question. Okay, to the tomorrow examination, except the three concepts, you are going to write the examination. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Vandal.